Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of The Twilight Zone Retro 3¾-inch action figures from Biff Bang Pow. This time of year, I love to marathon The Twilight Zone. Thank you, Netflix. It's one of my all-time favorite shows. So when Biff Bang Pow jumped onto that whole retro 3¾-inch action figure game and decided to give us some based on The Twilight Zone, I was all over them. So let's check these figures out. So as you can see, they come on that nice blister card packaging that is very reminiscent of those old 3¾-inch action figures, specifically what we saw with stuff like Star Wars. The packages are perfect because they feature the Twilight Zone logo up at the top of the card back. They got that great kind of starry background with all of those crazy little things that fly at you at the beginning of the episodes. And then to the right of all of the figures, we have images taken straight out of the episodes that they're based upon. Flipping these packages around to the back, all of them are exactly the same, showing you all of the figures that are currently available on the line and giving you a brief description of the Twilight Zone action figures. Alright, so let's go ahead and rip these guys open and take a look at them one by one. And we'll go ahead and start things off with Henry Bemis from Episode 8, Time Enough at Last. Henry Bemis is a character who just wanted to read, but life was so crazy and busy he never had the time to do it until all of a sudden there were no people left in the world. There was time enough at last to read. This action figure's really nicely done. Now you'll notice right off the bat there's a theme going on here. All of these figures are painted black and white, which is perfect in my opinion, since that's the way these episodes aired, and that's the way you picture these characters in black and white. The paint job is very nice and clean on this figure for the most part. However, if you flip around to the backside, I do unfortunately have some paint splotches on the back of his jacket. I will say this is the only figure in this line that I've got that issue with though, and at least it's on the back of the figure. Otherwise, I do love the sculpt. It's a great representation of the character straight out of the show. I love the big Coke bottle glasses on his face, how they chose to kind of not paint the eyes to really give that thickness effect to the glasses. It looks really cool. I think it's really great because these are done in that retro style, so they are meant to look like how a Twilight Zone figure might have looked if it came out back in the 70s or the 80s. But these still do a really good job of looking like the characters from the show, as you'll see as we flip through all of the figures here. Of course, Henry Bemis comes with two accessories, both being books, because that's what he loved. He loved his books. You got one that's black and one that's more gray, and you can get them fit in his hands so he can hold on to his books there and get ready to enjoy them. I guess the only thing this figure is lacking is removable glasses so that he can lose them at the wrong moment. Next up in the lineup, we have Canemit from episode 89, To Serve Man. This is that cool alien who came down. He said it was peace. They came in peace. They wanted to be friends with the Earthlings, and they were going to take them all back to their planet to show them off. Well, this guy here is another one that's translated very nicely. You can see it's a great sculpt on there. Paint job is pretty good. He's got that same kind of black and white look. I do sort of wish we had a little bit more black under the eyes to really give him that sunken in eyes look that the character has from the series, but for the most part, he looks great. You look at this guy, you recognize the character exactly. He also comes with his own accessory, which is another book, and you can see it's got their native language printed on it, but of course, as we all came to find out, that language translated to serve man, as in to serve him for dinner. This is a cookbook! Perfect accessory for this guy. Next figure in the lineup is from one of my favorite episodes, episode 126, The Living Doll. This is Talkie Tina. So she's one of the characters in this lineup that's actually based on an inanimate object, or I guess slightly inanimate. This isn't an actual person or a creature, but yet a kid's toy. So it's smaller in scale. It's actually about the right size of a doll when you compare him to some of the other figures in the line, like the more humanoid ones. She's a great looking little sculpt there. She's a little more cartoony looking, of course, because she's meant to look like a doll. But even like the little sculpting, the way the mouth is shaped on the face and everything, does a pretty good job of looking like the doll from the cartoon series. She may look sweet and innocent, but if you're kind of an evil dad who's mean to his daughter, well, she's going to probably come at you and say things like, "I'm Talkie Tina and I'm going to kill you." Great character and a really fun little action figure. All right, The Invader, another one of my favorite episodes, one of the best episodes in my opinion. Episode 51, it's almost a completely silent episode where we saw these tiny little alien invaders walking around terrorizing this poor woman, only to find out at the end that these little guys were from Earth, and they had apparently crash-landed on a planet full of giants! Yeah, so this little action figure here is probably about the same size the actual invaders were in the series. He's got a completely different shape than all the other figures, he's kind of more rounded, and another thing that's different about him, he's got a metallic silver paint job to kind of mimic the reflective nature of his costume in the series there. But still very kind of monochrome with the black and whites there, he just has a bit more of a shine to him. But great looking figure all around, perfect sculpt, it's a great representation of exactly how the character looked in the series. Now, he does come with two accessories, both being the little laser light things he was holding in his hand and blinking in the episode. And the weird thing about these is they're the only thing in this entire line that are in color, as they've got a little glowing green look to them. I actually kind of wish they were more black and white, but I imagine Biff Bang Pow was trying to give it away to look like it was lit up. But it does look a little strange since everything else is black and white. Not sure why those came in color. All right. Everybody knows this episode, right? This is Bob Wilson from episode 123, Nightmare at 20,000 Feet. This is one of William Shatner's episodes, way back before he was Captain Kirk, of course. And this is the famous episode where there was something on the wing. He was on an airplane and he saw something on the wing. It's a great figure. Obviously, it's just a guy in a business suit, but you know what? Even though this is a vintage-looking toy, definitely still has a bit of a Captain Kirk, William Shatner likeness to it, you know? It's very nicely done, and for an accessory, it even comes with a revolver. Yep, revolver on an airplane. It was a way different time back then. But to go right along with that, we get another figure from that episode. So this is the only figure in the line where we get two figures from the same episode, but we gotta have this guy. It's the Gremlin from the same episode. This is the crazy thing that Shatner saw out there on the wing. And again, awesome likeness. It was such a weird looking character in the show. He had this big, crazy, fuzzy outfit and this really ugly face, and he just looks really cool as a retro 3¾-inch action figure. So all of the figures look really nice, their paint jobs are cool, I love the monochrome look to them. And they all have the exact same type of articulation for the most part. So it's very basic, just like we got back in the day, with the heads just turning left and right, the arms moving up and down, and the legs moving up and down. And all of the articulation's nice and tight, so they stand well on their own and everything. The only one that's slightly different, of course, is the Invader, due to his shape. His head doesn't turn, his arms just move up and down, and then the legs are also stuck in place, so there's no articulation except the arms on that guy, but he still works out just fine. He looks great. All of the figures are nice and solid, great construction, and I really do like the sculpts on these guys. I think for retro style figures, Biff Bang Pow did a good job of still making them look like their counterparts from the classic TV series. Now, if the black and white look isn't your thing, Biff Bang Pow also released exclusives at San Diego Comic-Con this year featuring full color versions of all of these figures. However, I will say that I don't actually like them as much as the black and white ones. I prefer the black and white because that's just the way I think of Twilight Zone, and I think it looks really cool. But if full color is more your style, those are available out there for you as well. So there you go, my friends. There's a look at the new retro-style 3¾-inch Twilight Zone figures from Biff Bang Pow. Really love this little series. I really hope we get to see more characters from the show because there's so many great episodes, and I would love to collect some cool little action figures based on them. So you can buy these at specialty shops and online toy stores right now. So happy haunting, my friends. And until next time.